At breakfast, the morning of the party, Millie found it difficult to keep a pretense of interest in anything so prosaic as toast and chops. She plied Bob with questions. She worried him with her misgivings. She quit her seat to embrace her mother violently. Then she was off to the kitchen and dragging Kitty, the maid, up two flights to view the creation in pink and white beneath the chandelier. A while later, the restless Millie stood out upon the front steps, gazing up into the misty October sky in search of weather indications upon which she might base some prognostications of her own. It was then that the postman came along and with a polite greeting handed her the morning mail. Quite a batch of it. She slowly turned into the house, glancing over the circulars and letters, and in a manner assorting them. There was a letter to her mother from her Aunt Jane. She knew the stiff, formal handwriting, mailed from the distant town in which her Aunt Mildred lay sick. A dread that for the moment made her feel faint took possession of Millie. She crept into the quiet parlor and sat there undisturbed, staring at the outside of her Aunt Jane's letter. Her fingers seemed to feel for the annoyance which that sealed envelope might cover. Her eyes seemed to penetrate and unveil the threat against her longed-for and looked-for pleasure. What difference would a day make? She turned and turned the letter about. What difference could a day make? None whatever, as Millie counted days. Yet she could feel her heart thump with guilty excitement as she slipped the letter into her pocket. She then went on upstairs and laid the mail in the usual place upon the sitting room table, glad that her mother was not there at the moment to unmask her shame-faced consciousness. It was a hateful occurrence that threw a damper upon her joy. During the school hours, the letter concealed in her pocket seemed like a live thing, a reptile, a slimy thing. When her hand accidentally encountered it, she almost made up her mind to deliver it to her mother when she returned at 3 o'clock. Oh, but the merry time ahead! What chatter! Like the twittering sparrows among the russet leaves as the girls walked home beneath the trees. What breathless chatter of gowns, of hair ornaments, of slippers and fluttering ribbons. But Millie knew there was nothing that would compare with the pink and white cloud floating beneath the chandelier in her room. All her eagerness returned, and nothing marred it, not even the sight of her mother's face, perplexed with an uneasy sadness. Bob was distinctly proud of his pretty sister when she stood outside for household inspection that night, but he would have considered it an unpardonable weakness to say so.
You'll do, Millie. Rub some of the paint off your cheeks.
Oh, what a joke! Kitty, the maid, howled at the humor of it. You'll be after her to take the sparkle out of her shining eyes next, Mr. Bob. Go away with ye! Millie, in a joyous state, turned into a show window robot, while the gentle mother enveloped her in a fleecy white cape, brought to light for the occasion from the relic trunk. There have been thousands of parties exactly like that one, but no one could have made Millie believe so. What applause at her recitation! What side-splitting laughter over the charades! What a hush of appreciation over the beautiful tableaus! And then, the attentions of the college boys, the compliments, the mountains of ice creams, the islands of sponge cakes, the running river of lemonade! Millie's excitement held her all the way home. Clinging to Bob's arm, her little nervous steps kept a dancing pace to his unthinking stride. It followed her to her very pillow. But there, before she closed her eyes, a lull came upon her senses. The joy all melted out of her soul, and the vision of a letter held sway in her dreams all through the night. There was nothing haphazard in the fact that Millie stationed herself upon the front steps the following morning. She was pale. Something had, as Bob would have said, rubbed the paint off her cheeks, and that same something had taken the sparkle out of her eyes and left in its stead a dull anxiety. She was waiting for the postman. When he handed her the scanty mail, she added to the pile the letter in her pocket and carried it directly to her mother, who sat at the sitting-room table, bending over some sewing. Millie did not withdraw, but stood there, watching at a little distance. Somehow, she was not startled when the letter trembled in her mother's hand, when the tears gathered and fell upon the fluttering sheets.
"What is it, mother?"
asked Millie. In a dry voice that did not sound to her like her own, she darted forward and with an encircling arm drew her mother's head against her throbbing heart.
"What is it, mother dear? What makes you cry?"
"Your Aunt Mildred cannot recover. The doctors have given her up. I am going. I must go to her."
Rising with agitation and clasping Millie closely,